Hey Legionnaires, and welcome back. We're here with another Rome 2 Siege for you today, and this one is an epic one. It's a long one as well, so definitely get some snacks and some drinks and get ready for a great Siege battle. It is definitely worth sticking around to the end to see this one as we wrap up Siege Week. I hope you guys have enjoyed. Please let me know whether you'd like to see another Siege Week in the future in the comments, and thank you for all the likes and subs and comments recently. Keeping up that support, keep it up guys, and let's get into this video. So anyway, we have a 3v3 for you today. I am playing as Nabatea with two of my allies and subs, Aiden, who is playing as Egypt, and we have Dodgy Gob playing as Bactria. So we are up against, who are we up against today? We're against up another Bactrian army. Kush always seems to be attacking me these days. And we have the Arvani, who also seems to strangely become a favourite for multiplayer people. Let me know in the comments who you like to attack with or defend with if you're playing multiplayer sieges, or who's your favourite faction in Rome 2 if you don't play multiplayer. A very good shot there from a siege artillery is out here. Going to knock down some walls, hopefully. So yes, it looks like a few kills there against the general of the Arvani. Not a bad target to go after. As long as you don't general snipe, just weaken him for later. I find that's okay. We also have some shots going off over here. Looks like a siege tower is going to get knocked down. It's at 40%, 19 fire damage. So it's just an early build-up as we go now. It's just lots of artillery shots just getting hit against, like, look at that. This one is getting absolutely battered. Gonna be persistent. That one missed. That was shocking. 72% damage. Is it gonna get another one? 80%. Go on, another one. Will the Shota Warriors realize? Oh, they missed both of them. That's huge. That might be enough to stop, to save this siege tower. 88%. Just about realized what's gonna happen. That's a shame. Could have taken out an entire siege tower there and could have done enough damage. This one over here is the next one at 8%. But yeah, so we have decided to bring just like a load of all sorts of stuff, really. We've got a lot of Palace Guard, lots of Galatian Royal Guard, lots of elite units. We have a lot of cavalry back here. Bactrian Noble Horse, Bactrian Royal Cavalry, all ready for a sally out. And then we've got, well, I seem to be playing as Nabatea a lot, basically. I enjoy playing Nabatea. One of my favourite factions, I think, now. I don't know what it is about them, but they're goddamn awesome. So we've brought plenty of archers as well to get ready. I think every single attacking army has brought artillery, so there's going to be plenty of breaches being made. Actually, I think Bactria's not brought any. But he brought elephants instead. They're their own siege tower in themselves. They're already a bit bloodied up. They're already a little bit bloodied up. I think they were hit with artillery. Some of these Thorax swords have been pretty beaten up. I mean, yeah, there's one here, 109, already very beaten up before it's even gone to combat. That's very good. That's what we need. He's also brought an interesting army, as Kush. He's bringing a lot of swordsmen, which I knowing like the amount of money that was like available to them, they could have definitely brought better stuff than swordsmen. And he's not even chevroned them up that well, so that's an interesting decision. He's also brought a lot of Shota Warriors. You would have thought he'd have brought more armored Shota Warriors. He only looks like he's brought four. And he could definitely do possibly more if he's going to break through this these walls, possibly. We will see. But there are some nasty units over here as well from the Arvani. He's brought a lot of those sworn, as expected. Chosen Warriors, Spear Nobles. It's got all sorts ready. Bactria's got a nice little wall he's only got to defend. He's only got to defend this real area here as well. Unless they make any holes in the wall, but they can only make some here and only make some here. And hopefully, we are going to have some engagement in a moment. Here we go, the cavalry's going out. By the looks of it, the cavalry's going to go out this gate because it's the only way out, because it looks like Kush and Bactria are just going to not attack from this side and save problems. So where's the gate? Where is the gate, actually? There's a gate there. There's also a gate here. There's a gate here. It's just the nearer one. Probably go out there. And then they can either start harassing Kush or, well, they could take out this light horse unit over here that the Arvani just decided to leave it. Interesting decision to leave light horse there. I guess it's kind of a good flat. It kind of keeps an eye, make sure that nothing's over here when they are busy attacking. Keeps a line of sight. But I am... when are we going to see the first attack? It looks like very soon. So I'll probably put in a cut, or like put in a time for you guys that want to see, like when the battle actually starts, because this is a long one. So I will make sure that there is like a number if I haven't already put it in. When you are time, sorry, not a number. A number, just the number four. But anyway, here we go. So it looks like it's going to be the Shota Warriors that are down first onto the wall. They are ready to take on the Nabataean. It looks like some Rakim Palace Guard down here. A very elite unit. Definitely one to not mess with. Are they going to go straight in? I don't think so. They just look like they're going to try and capture this tower. And they're going to throw javelins straight down at these guys. Not a bad decision. Going to need a lot of javelins though to do some damage to these guys. And we already have... Oh no! They're going to take out our brave artillery men. The bastards. They've killed those men. I mean, they killed a lot of Bactrians. Yeah, there you go. They can have their first cheer. They have the first cheer. There's going to be a lot of pain from here on in. Also, Rakim Palace Guard all the way down here ready to fight out. And here we go. We've got on the wall. Thorax Pikes, the first onto the wall. A very bold move to put Pikemen first on the wall since, well... They don't have many units of pikes, but here we go. They're going to get absolutely destroyed by arrow fire. Yeah, that is not pleasant. And yeah, I mean, these Nabataean archers have got a very nice little angle here. You can just see those guys all the way up there. They are now getting, I thought they were getting hit with something, but they're not, they're just destroying a wall. They're that strong, they can just destroy walls. And we've got another target here, who is this? This looks like Kersh with those swordsmen. Or Shota Warriors. Yeah, an even better target. I mean, they're not as good as, say, Pikemen, who are now off the wall and they've gone back down, by the looks of it. There's not many of them, I'd say there's not many of them left. There is quite a few of them left still. Looks like there's just a bit of confusion really on this wall, but this is a huge blob that needs to be hit. Oh, the archers, really. Like, Shota Warriors. Bactrian Royal Guard. Excellent targets to be shooting at. Rakim Palace Guard also being focused on over here with arrows. They've already lost 10 men. Going to be useful having those guardsmen. And these ones are taking an absolute beating as well. But it is fine. We will have to endure. We're not giving up these areas. We can't let them just take these towers for nothing. So, we'll hold here. And here we go. The first real engagement is about to begin. It looks like it's going to be Bactrian Royal Guard going in against some Rakim Palace Guard. Who's going to win? Which guardsman will win? I imagine probably the Palace Guard, mainly because they've not been under fire as much. And these guys are coming through in a very small one, like narrow formation. Not many of them through. And hit Palace Guard are like all nicely blobbed up, ready to stab them. Yeah, look at that. Fighting their way through this Palace Guard. I'm not sure if they're going to be able to get through. Does look like he pulled through a bit there, but who knows? Who knows? That definitely doesn't look right, but you can't always get the same. People seem to be doing it a lot, so. Yeah, the Palace Guard now. I'm sure they're winning that fight. Yeah, they're winning decisively. And they're paying the price of those Bactrian Royal Guard for their decisions. And here we go. Elephants already coming up to what? I'm not sure where they're really going to get in. Maybe through the gates? They're really going to go through these gates? Are they knocked down? No, they're not even knocked down. I think that's what he realized. He thought he could get through these gates here with his elephants, but no, they've not been knocked down by a gate. They just opened because I think these Palace Guard just was so near to them. But interesting, should have really focused these guys down with arrows. That would have been really good. I think all our archers are focusing all the way over here, looking at all these Palace Guard. This is, or Royal Guard, sorry. Look at this, it's disgusting. This is a lot of Bactrian noble, or guardsmen that just shouldn't be dying. They're dying for no reason. This is excellent. Excellent for us. We need to kill off as many of these guardsmen as possible and just make sure they keep doing it. Egypt doing the same over here. He's focusing down on all these, this pikeman up here. Wow. That's a bad decision by Bactra here, just throwing in his pikes. Especially when they can't actually get their pikes down. They're just fighting in a wall formation. Who are they fighting against? Some Thorax Swords. Yeah, they'll mop them up. And the Thorax Swords should probably hold against these Bactrian Royal Guard for an okay amount of time. They, like, hardly any of them are really fighting. It's, like, just mainly, like, one or two. Oh, it looked like a lot of friendly fire there. What is firing down here, then? Thorax Swordsmen throwing their javies up. But, yeah, they should hold okay. Looks like more fighting down going on down here. Looks like the Bactrian Guardsmen are causing enough problems, and they're now they're pulling back. I think they've had enough up there, and they're going to pull back. Oh, seven of them left. Wow, they broke. Or this, I don't know. There's a lot of stuff going on here. Is Arvani on the wall? He is. He is actually on the wall, and he's not facing any opposition. Also killed his the artillery there. It's just a shame, but it happens. It's what happens after you fire at will. Look at these boys. They look beautiful. On the walls, just doing their bit. Yes, cheer away. Yes, yes. There's a lot of troops out here that are just waiting to come in. I'm not really sure what they're doing. I think they're actually throwing javelins down. Yeah, look at this Rakim Palace Guard. It's down to 39. I think quite a lot of them got javied. But they need support up here. They need to send in some, maybe some Bactrian Royal Guard. These ones here are freed up. I mean, it actually looks like there's some Noble Swords going in. Noble Swords are going to go and save the day. And the breach has been opened. A breach has been opened. The Arvani is going to try and get his way through it, and the elephants are in. Okay, the elephants are in. It looks like Bactria is fighting his Bactrian rival. The two Bactrians finally face to face. These elephants don't look like they're doing too much damage, and they're getting lots of javies inside, and that's excellent. Look at all the amount of javies in that one. Jeez, that must have been like almost 20, like a whole volley just to take out one elephant. But it does look like the Arvani being held back for now. Lots of elite Oathsworn in here. A brutal fight in this breach here. But I mean, you do wonder in time, will these swords be able to overwhelm these spears? They really should be able to. They might need to form shield wall. I don't know if they are in shield wall. They don't look like they are. Actually, they might be. Like, the front line looks like they might have formed shield wall. It's just that people keep breaking out of shield wall to go and have their own little jewels, and they go and die for it. But they're beating these chosen swords here. These Oathsworn are pretty beaten up. Thorax swords here just ready. And it looks like the elephants are pulled back. How many did they lose? They lost two. That's two elephants that could be handy later. But, yes, it's looking like an okay defense for now. Holding them back. They're getting in, obviously, off the walls. This is going to be huge. This is a wall that's about to break here, 63%. He's got Bactrian Royal Guard going across, just being very careful. Yep. You need to be very careful when you're firing this. So the heavy onager back there is going to keep firing. We have a unit here of Thorax Swords that's coming next. Will they be hit? They may be hit. We'll see. Oh, it looks like... I don't know. This is really under threat, though, down here. This is a real big problem. These swordsmen are now starting to lose. And a breach is going to be opened up here. And it looks like 92%. It looks like this Thorax Swords unit here is going to make a big mistake. Clearly, the player for Bactria here was not realizing what's happening. And they're killed by his own allied artillery. So many men lost. So that is a unit that was at basically full strength. It's down to 85. Because of that, and they're getting focused down for their own good. Like, you idiots, you shouldn't have done that. I'm sure the Bactrian player was probably very angry at his Kush player, and I'm sure the Kush player was also very angry at him for making the mistake. But here we go. So it looks like archers are now going to respond and focus down on the Nabataean archers here. Kush is had enough, and he's going to just start focusing them down. And it looks like I don't know what the Thorax Swords unit is doing, but it's certainly not doing anything good. They're actually having to send some archers in here that had run out of ammo to hold back Chota warriors. Not good. So a unit really needs to get up here. Clearly, we were too focused on actually sorting out... I don't know. Just like looking at what was happening, we weren't actually sorting out the problem. So it looks like they're actually going to get in this breach here. This is worrying. This is actually not good. This is the first real mistake the defenders have made. Or we've made, I should say. I am part of the defenders. And just leaving a small unit of archers here to hold back this Shota Warrior unit. And they'll mince them with these Shota Warriors. Is there anything on its way? There is actually another Noble Swordsman unit. It is on the way. A fairly fresh unit. They might be able to hold these guys back. But it's going to have to be pretty soon. And it looks like Bactria is breaking through here as well. Looks like these Noble Swords are basically finished. There's 94 of them left, though. They keep losing decisively. They're up against a lot of stuff. It's literally every army's here. Kush, the Arvani, Bactria, all in there. And here we go. Chopping away. Nabatea holding his own. How's Bactria doing over here? Looks like he's doing okay now. He's sticking the line with some Thorax swords. They actually look like they've been pushed back if they were sworn. Nearly back out the breach that they were coming through. And more... Now it's Thorax swords of the other Bactrian player. Or the enemy Bactrian player coming through. And he's going to try and push his way through, it would seem. Excellent. So yes, they will hopefully try and break their way through. It looks like the gate is almost done, dealt with as well. Chosen Swordsman breaking here. They are looking at numbers, losing here. Though they are apparently beating these Thorax Swords, which are being javied from above by Oathsworn. So that's very good. And there we go. They've broken through here. This is the... I think these are the Shota Warriors that came through here. Then they went past. And now Bactria's had to send up some Bactrian Royal Guard to hold these guys back. So this is the first real sign that the defenders aren't able to hold that this front line at the walls. And there we go. The Noble Swordsmen have broken and this corner is now freed up. And they're able to put more pressure on Bactria here and any formation that's going on over here. Egypt's finally sending some stuff up to come and support. He's got most of his army in reserves. So he's not really actually having to do much. But here we go. He's sending some Thorax Swords in. And they'll fight these swordsmen, who they should really mop up. They are swordsmen. They're one of the lower tier units that Kush brings, or Kush can bring. And more Shota Warriors spewing through that breach. And they look like they're getting ready to join the fight as well. Here they come. Straight in, they'll support. And that'll probably even out the fight against the Thorax Swords. As the swordsmen are already breaking. As expected, to be honest, they are a terrible, terrible unit to really bring as Kush. Especially when you have the money to bring better stuff. Yeah, swordsmen are getting just cornered in here as well. Poor guys. 70 guys cornered into this small area here. Look to the standard bearer indeed, as they always say. If you can't, if you don't know where to look, look for the standard bearer. That's definitely not a saying, but the Romans certainly used it. That's why they have the eagle. If in doubt, find an eagle, and that's a friendly, hopefully. Unless it's a stolen eagle. Images of Teutoburg Forest flash before my eyes. Damn Arminius and his sneaky boy tactics. But as we're reminiscing on past failures, it looks like there's been a failure here to really hold back the Arvani, as they've broken that unit there, and now Thor Spears having to be sent in to hold them back, and they're probably going to get overwhelmed. They're currently drawing now, but these are Oathsworn, and this is a fresh unit. They're going to mince these guys, and now more Bactrian Royal Guard being sent up. So Bactrian's sending up a lot of stuff, really, to hold back here. He's really committing a lot of his stuff. What's he got back here? He's got more Royal Guard, Thorax Pikes, and then he's got more is general, and that's really it. Bactria's almost spent. That's actually Bactria nearly done. Egypt looks very fresh, and then myself as Nabatea looking okay as well. You kind of just got to make sure that you're looking for the right Bactrian player as well, because like Bactria here, the defender has blue, and then the attacker has red around this side of his flag. So you just need to make sure that is the case. Like there, for instance, very confusing. You could think Bactria could surround him, but no. Surround Kush, but no. And looks like Kush is rinsing these noble... I keep wanting to call them noble spearmen, but they're not. They're They are royal guard. There's no noble in there. They are royal. Royalty, not nobility. And it looks like Bactria's going to send in his own royal guard to deal with this. He's like, well, Kush isn't doing a good enough job. I mean, though they have the support of the Arch Tower back then, it's definitely thinning the lines here. Looks like Bactria is now breaking. That is not a good sign. It now looks like there's going to be a Thorough Spear unit here that is going to be holding this choke point in a square formation. Not a bad idea. This is a very hard formation to break down. And it looks like Thorax Pikes are being mobilized by the Bactrian player. And what's it? He has a lot of stuff in here. So much stuff. So many Royal Guard. Just trying to see what his other pikeman unit is. Oh, it's back here. Okay, so he has one that's on the road, moving up, and it looks like Egypt's going to fall back his Thorough Spears, and the pikes are going to get sent in. A nice little volley there. Don't think he got many kills, but it was a nice little volley. But this is a concern. They're starting to build up forces in it. They've got a nice little like landing stage now where they can just drop men off and then send them in. And Egypt's being forced to send in more Thorax swords, it would seem. They don't look like they need it just yet. They seem to be holding okay. But they're ready in there. Rakim Palace Guard ready. What's this now coming on towards? More Shota warriors. And they're just going to get focused on anything that's coming onto this wall, as you can see, like on top of the walls. It's just getting focused down. Now there's a. What's this? This is now some Shota warriors now fighting the small unit of Palace Guard. We'll see how they do. I think this could be a fairly even fight because these Palace Guard are not easy to beat. Oh, just as one gets stabbed there. Poor man. Getting focused down by arrows, though, these Shota warriors. And that looks like a pull through, to be honest. That, I think, by Kush was a pull through because the Shota warriors there are still holding. Palace Guardmen are still holding there. And they've definitely just pulled through that. And here we go. It looks like Egypt's now having to send in his Thorax swords here to deal with this problem. The ones that he's going to keep in reserve to fight over there. And now we have the Onagers in the background. They're coming in. This is not a good sign. They're sending in their weapons of war to basically do damage on us. I think they're just going to like just fire anything that's reserved for us right now. And there we go. Bactria's falling back. Bactria's not going to hold this breach point over here anymore. He's decided it's too costly. Too costly to hold. And Egypt's going to have to sacrifice some Thorax swords, as is Bactria, along with some other stuff, really. He's just sacrificing a few units to hold them back. Real shame. Here we go. Some volleys of artillery coming in. It looks like they're trying to focus some stuff down with a Celtic Ballista. Not a bad decision. And we can't forget this Bactrian Royal Cavalry back here. I'm not sure where the other one is. I thought they had a third unit of cavalry. I may be wrong. I thought they had a third unit of cavalry somewhere, though. But where are they? Where are they? Here they are. Bactrian Royal Cavalry. They're ready. They look elite. Nasty. Expect some... it looks like they got... I think they do. I was like, I think they got like pieces of grass. It looks like they're sticking out of them, out of the back of them. But they all do. Yeah, I've never realised that. They have ferns on the back of their... on their backs. And then now the order's been given. They're going, I think, they're going to try and take out Kush and his general. Because Kush is looking the most... I wouldn't say the most healthy, but he's just looking the most vulnerable, being the only unit on its own. Only unit. I was right the first time. Only faction. And he's got a lot of... archers back here, a lot of soft units can be beaten up by these disciples of Atapenmac. Very light, so they can definitely be run down. But he's ready. He's got all his men defending, and there we go. It looks like the light horse unit, which clearly has come all the way from the other side of the battle, is getting ready, as are the elephants. And Kush is going to send his general in, which is a big risk. And there we go. There's a clash of cavalry. And the light horse is getting ready to come in. And that's going to support this fight. And the other unit of Royal Cavalry getting ready to encircle the general. They're losing decisively. So Kush may lose his general here. Light horse. That was a lot of damage for the light horse unit. That's probably good. They're probably going to die just because of this. A really foolish decision just to charge all this shock cavalry. But here we go. Looks like is he sending in pikemen? Yeah, they'll certainly munch up these Bactrian noble cavalry like they're nothing. And they are actually getting, like, charging into the formation, but these guys are just going to get, stabbed to death. Poked to death. Now they've got archer support firing on them. And now Arvani's sending in his general. There's a lot of stuff being committed just to take out this cavalry. And unfortunately, the cavalry is going to die before it could achieve any objective of taking out Kush's general. A real shame. And there we go. So Bactria had an idea, but the idea did not pull off. So he is unfortunately going to have to think again on what he's actually going to do. He's actually not got too many men left. He's looking okay. He's got a lot of archers left. Hopefully they have a lot of ammo. We have a lot of stuff in reserve back here in the final defense. And that's how we hope to keep it. We are going to obviously defend the streets next, as we've given up the walls. Egypt managed to pull out some thorax swords and his archers from this fight. That he then had this. He sent in a load of stuff here to just hold Kush back, whilst we retreat everything else. But he's managed to get most of it out. He's only going to lose one unit of Cretan archers, which I'm pretty sure are out of ammo. Take a few Shota warriors with him. But Kush is looking really good. He's got all his archers left. And he doesn't look like he's fired much ammo. Same with Arvani. He's got most of his archers left. And again, not fired any ammo, really. They've just been minding their own business, staying at the back. I think they might fight a little bit, but not masses. Now, Bactria here is firing, like, just into this huge blob that's, like, forming up here. Not a bad target, to be honest. Shooting archers. Taking names. And there we go, he's going to respond his Gaul, or not Gaul, Arvani. And this is a huge blob of archers that needs to really be sorted out. This is going to be very easy for them to take names, like they already have been. There's a lot of them here. And here we go, Bactria's going to hold the line. And these spears here, they're not going to hold. They're not spears, those archers. They have got spears, but they won't hold. And here we go, the first clash of the next defense is going to be between Bactria and Arvani. They should hold here for a while. This is a very nice, easy choke point to hold. And they have archer support as well. I know they probably need to pull some of these archers back, though. And now more thorax swords getting sent in and back to Royal Guard. Wow, they're really blobbing up. This is a really good target to aim for now. Like, the archers, they really should be focusing down them. And Kush's general is up here, along with pikes. Definitely a chance to take out the general if you have archers. So there you go. Nabataean heavy archers being sent forward, along with more Bactrian archers. They're going to try and take out this general. They're not like... The balance of power, not in favor of the defenders now. They've got to try some tactics. Try and take out this general. They'll still have two generals left with the attackers. But it could be huge. There you go, he's realised what's happening. He's lost about 10 men, though, in the making of that. Now's the time to focus on the pikes, because he's going out the gates. He's lost even more. Wow. Very unlucky not to get him. But the pikes going up here, they're going to try and dislodge Egypt, which is now defending this little choke point down here with some more thorax swordsmen, the bread and butter of the Hellenic armies. Here they are, ready to go. The Shota warriors ready as well, armored Shota warriors as well. They look like they're really building up a force to come down here. Really going to punch through. And here we go. It looks like there's some depleted units of swordsmen being sent in first. Not a bad idea. Fighting against a noble swordsman unit. They'll hold. They'll beat these swordsmen quite easily. And here we go. The Battle of the Desert Factions. See who wins. And there you go. We got our answer very quickly. Nabatea won the first fight, it looks like. Some swordsmen already breaking. I mean, these men do have gold armor. They are fighting men in gold armor, and these swordsmen have tunics on. It does seem a little unfair, but why send in strong units when you have weak units? And now some Shota warriors are in there, another weak unit, and some armored Shota warriors now coming in. This is the first real test by Kush. This is the first real push that he's making, like with some good units. Armored Shota warriors, if you don't know, probably one of the strongest units. Well, certainly in this faction, and maybe not, and maybe in the game as well. Certainly in choke points like this, they'll rinse through stuff. We just witnessed it over here. Oh dear, my voice went weird then. we witnessed it here. I try to say, with Bactrian Royal Guard, they just got rinsed, and you can see like the amount of bodies that are down here. There is very few armor Shota warriors. About two or three, maybe. I think this might be that unit because it's a little bit beaten up. But we've only killed a couple of them ourselves here. They are apparently. Oh no, that's Shota warriors. They're winning decisively. Yes. And yeah, Noble Swordsman losing. They really need to send in this Sauric Soldier, and it's just behind here. Just send it in. Thicken this line. Try and slow down these Armor Shota warriors. I'm not sure how much ammo the defenders have left. Egypt looks like he's got some. Maybe. I think these archers might be out as well. And the slingers look like they're out. I think they've all got their swords out, which is an easy way to tell if you have ammo left. Nabatea also looks like might be out of ammo. I'm not sure, actually. They do look like they might have their bows out. If these Royal Guard would move, and these Thorax Swords would move... Yeah, they look like they're out. Oh, no, they still got their bows out. Sorry, they've got them in their left hand. That's the difference, so... So they still have ammo. That's huge. Egypt might has ammo up here, actually. These Korean archers have ammo. And they're focusing down on the pikes here. Really good target to go for, pikemen. Already at 99... Jeez, these guys are getting absolutely destroyed. That's really good for them. I mean, they're only fighting Thorax Swords, who are losing. But these pikes are breaking. Now the Armored Shota Warriors are the next in line to get hit. I mean, they'll probably force their way through. But yeah, that's a really good volley. Oh, wow. Yes. Excellent. If you're rooting for the defenders, then that's huge. Kush has lost his first unit of pikes. Now Shota Warriors in here, which will do just fine against these swords. And he's sending up troops onto the wall is Egypt. He's got Royal Peltasts up here. Trying to get these archers. Not a bad target to go for. Try and take out those archers. Really should commit to that attack though. He really should just go in and take these guys out. Because then he could force his way down. There's not much. Actually, there is some Osworn down there and some Shota warriors. But there's a lot of very easy, juicy archers you could take out. And if you could break through here, you could get those archers as well. But as you can see, there's a long time left in this battle. So I hope you guys are enjoying it. Because, well, there's a lot more to come. And it gets even more epic as we go on. Bactrian Royal Guard still holding here. This is still the same unit. And it's holding against an even bigger blob now. So if I think like the attackers just think they keep adding stuff to this, then it'll eventually just give way. Which it will. But not for a while. Not for a while indeed. And this is a bit weird. People are like being pushed back again. This is not a good sign. That it looks like someone would be trying to push through, because that's what happens, I find, when people try to, well, pull through. And you can see like Thorax Swords just flying the way through. So that's not good. Yeah, there you go. Something's happening here. I think he's pulling through, because this is the enemy Thorax army, and they just pulled through. Yeah, you can see it there. Shouldn't be able to get through. This is a unit that's in a hoplite formation, and it's pulled through. So that's this Bactra player is cheating here, unfortunately. But yeah, and look at this. He's just surrounded. This unit now is condemned. It's now losing decisively. Only, and the Bactrian player clearly is just sick of this one unit holding back so much. He's just being impatient. He would break through anyway. This unit's going to lose. They've got so many men here. They'll eventually kill this man. That's the benefit of defending. You have less men to hold a very small area, but you have less men. That is the point. So you will eventually lose. So yeah, this Sorok Sword unit is now going to mince these guys just because the Bactrian player was impatient. So it does frustrate me, especially when we did such a good job of defending and we still are doing an okay job of defending. We've still got a few problems. The amount of archers left is a real concern. Like, I mean, all these archers over here, real concern. Luckily, it looks like some Gallic Hunters are about to break. 44 of them left. 37, 36. Yeah, they look like they've routed. Could really do with focusing more of them down. But yeah, look at this. Mercenary Syrian archers getting wrecked. Nabataeans, my small unit of Nabataeans now fleeing. They're going to set up over here and help support Egypt in his fight here. It looks like the Oathsworn are going to lose this fight here. 89 of them fighting 123, and they have a tower against them. Actually, the tower's no longer actually supporting, but yeah, they have arrows coming in from this position here. A nice little position, this. Oh, I think Egypt's just run out of ammo. But I'm able to take over with my Nabataean archers, and they're going to fire with what ammo they have left. We'll have a volley, men. Volley. Loose. That wasn't many arrows. Not very impressive. Yeah, you cheer, guys. You cheer. Is that you out of ammo, though? Or are you just waving your swords around? No, you still got ammo. But, I mean, yeah, they are going to lose that. They're losing decisively now. More arrows coming in. More Oathsworn die. And that's what matters. Yeah, I thought in the end I'd use them to actually some benefit in killing some men instead of just dying to archers back here from basically the entirety of Gaul and Kush. Or Arvani and Kush. But yeah, we have a real problem here now. We've got swords and archers basically holding back what's left here. It looks like Egypt's going to send more archers in just to hold this line. And he's Bactrians also send archers in to try and surround these Thorax swords, which are still here. Still haven't actually broken this Bactrian Royal Guard, so that's good. So at least his cheating, Bactrian's cheating has not disrupted the other Bactrian player from still causing a problem in this front line. They have their artillery all the way here. Look at this. This is a real worry as well. I think they still have ammo looking at their ballista. Looks like he's going to send some archers in. Have these guys got ammo, I wonder? Egypt is going to send archers in to basically deal with these Thorax swords. And he looks like they're not finished for holding this choke point here then. Even though it looks very dangerous over here. Some Royal Peltasts now coming out. They look like they're going to try and hold back the next wave of attackers, which is coming soon, because there you go, Kush is through. So these archers are kind of condemned. They just sent themselves in and like, oh, didn't realize that this was the final stand. But we do need to start worrying about this choke point here. Don't know whether these Galatian Royal Guard are going to pull back. These Peltasts could do with pulling back as well. Looks like the Thorax Swordsmen that were here before have died. Probably to the Army Show to Warriors. But now, yeah, it's Galatian Royal Guard, which are goddamn nasty. And they'll hold for a long time. They're just... Yeah, there you go. They've thrown a javy. Javi's at point-blank range. They kill a load of Shota Warriors. Jeez, that is nasty. Don't know what this formation is. It's like an L. Backwards L by the Shota Warriors. And there you go. I think that's them gone. I think that might be an armored Shota Warrior unit, actually. I'm not sure. I don't know. Like, some Shota Warriors seem to keep having a... Yeah, it was an armored Shota Warrior unit. There you go. I thought so. They had gold armor on, and they only broke at four men. Wow. That's a problem. Can't have that happening. Shota Warriors here look like they're losing decisively. Archers in the arrow tower here, and definitely not helping. They have two arrow towers here, which are really going to be coming in handy. And they you need to capture them from here and here, which, so it's going to be very hard. So we want to hold this choke point here for a long time. Just use every arrow that we can get out of them. And here we go, another fresh unit of Shota Warriors going in. Armored Shota Warriors, to be precise. Setting in the elites to fight the elites. Luckily, it looks like it was still holding this archshaft now, though it is getting captured ever so slowly. Not quite sure how, they're not really actually capturing it, because the Galatian Royal Guard are actually beyond the capture point, along with the Peltasts. And they've nearly beaten these Oathsworn, so it shouldn't really matter. There you go, the Oathsworn are defeated. They could now actually send this unit all the way around here and cause problems for generals or archers. There is another unit of armor showed to warriors here, but this is it. Like, to attack, they could just get around here. They could get a load of nasty stuff, and there you go. Onagers coming up. This is not a good sign. Looks like they still have their heavy onagers for ammo. These Royal Peltasts may be in for a rough time. Might get their perspective just for a bit. Look at what they've got. Look at this. If you were like in the front line, one of the bannermen. Imagine I'm the bannerman right now. He had a lot to say about the enemy, but yeah, the banner just there. All they see is artillery wheeling up. They're just like, oh god, what are we gonna face now? Just some fiery balls of justice, plus javelins. There you go, they're throwing their javelins. Gonna get some nasty kills on these Royal Guard back here. Anthoric swords, yep, that's what you get for invading this city. So you get a javelin to the back, and you can feel the pain. This guy here, he's got several in him. But there you go, some... We're going to have the first volley that's coming off. Missing. That's really good. That one got a good hit. That went right down the line. That got a very nice hit. And this one. Oh, that's a nasty hit. And these Peltasts here just got to endure this. And there it goes. Bounce back off the wall and in. The luck that the defender's got there. That one just missed. That was lucky. Another good. Actually, that was not a great hit. That hit like two guys. Of which one's going to get... Oh, I think the Bannerman just got taken out there. Oh, he's going to get up, I think. No, he's not. He's very dead. So, yeah. I was telling the Egypt player now just to watch the line of sight of the rocks. That one luckily missed. But they're now facing the wrong way on the arrows. But I was like, just keep moving them backwards and forwards. Keep moving them backwards and forwards. So that the rocks keep missing. Because this is going to be a problem otherwise. This Royal Peltast unit is just falling, it's just dying. And to hold this choke point here, we've got another unit ready, Rakim Palace Guard, ready to take their place if needs be. But yeah, there we go. He's forming shield wall. He's going to take the pain of the arrows. He's forming a smaller formation, so it's harder for the artillery to hit. That was a good hit. 98 of them left. Coming to half strength soon. Oh, 87. Yeah, this poor unit. You might want to just pull this unit back. But he's using up the ammo. That's the thing. I was saying, yes, you're going to lose this unit. But it's using up the ammo that, like, Kush is desperately going to need later on. And the arrows are being used up by Bactria. And it's all on one unit. And there we go. More fiery balls coming from the ballista of the Arvani. I think that was trying to hit Rakim Palace Guard, which did hit a little bit. I think they glanced them. But yes, we're now trying to spread out everything. There's a lot of stuff back here that needs to stop being spreaded out just so this avoids. And there you go, I've got archers going up. I was like, right, I'll send my archers up. They can take on the fire of the ballista, not the ballista, the onager and the archers. Because they're out of ammo. They're no longer necessary. And these poor Royal Peltasts are 40 men now. Let me know in the comments whether you think this is actually a tactic that you should do. Like, do you think we should, like, it's worth doing just sacrificing unit just to soak up ammo? Or do you think it's better just to fall back on the position and actually carry on fighting properly instead of just doing this? I mean, they're obviously being cowardly and they're just going to shoot every bit of ammo they have. So we were like, well, you can shoot at one unit instead of all of our units. And that was nasty. Those guys just moving into formation. Look at this guy. He's like, no. I got hit by an arrow, and yeah, this Royal Peltast unit's gonna barely killed anyone. And my archers, just look at them, they're like, no, don't even look at what's coming. And there they go, they're gonna break. And as are the, neither are breaking. Actually, no, they have just broken then. And now it looks like Bactria's had enough, he's gonna send up some troops. Which is what we like to see. I didn't really want them to carry on shooting. So it looks like they're going to be a gentleman and they're going to shoot. It looks like also Egypt was allowed to pull his men out because well, there's not many bodies down here. He did look like he pulled out his men, and it looks like, yeah, there's a fairly fresh unit of Galatian Royal Guard. I think this is the Galatian Royal Guard that's in combat. Yeah, these two here, pretty beaten up. Egypt's not got much left either. It's basically down to Nabatea with most of the troops left. Egypt and Bactria are probably about the same, but we'll see what happens. Got pikemen over here with Galatian Royal Guard. At least, like, the units that Egypt and Bactria have left are really elite. He has, like, Royal Guard. More, but I mean, the balance power is not looking good. Balance power is awful right now, but here we go. So it looks like it's going to be some Rakim Guard going up. They focused down a little bit of us on the, with the artillery. What I'm trying to say. Artillery. And here we go. Swords going in as well to support these Rakim Palace Guard. And they're going to fight it to the death. They're like, well, you've just murdered a load of our brothers with boulders. We're going to murder you with our spears. I guess is what you might say. You might say that. Yeah, that guy, he's had enough. He's going to force this guy down. Look at him. That's like a war with their shields. Like, who's got more strength? In the end, doesn't like either side had enough strength to kill him. Yeah, it looks like lots of reserves ready. Look at this, the sun beating down on their backs. And there you go, another pull through by Bactria. He pulled through. This is the most obvious one. He literally pulls his unit through to try and surround our men. And this is when I kind of lost it. I was just like, no, you cannot do this. And I was like, Egypt, send in this unit, Galatian Royal Guard. Make him feel the pain for doing this. This is, I mean, they are losing decisively now, but I was like, no, I'm not having it. And luckily, he doesn't engage with the rest of his army to engage the rear of our troops. So we're actually able to mince these guys up quite nicely. So, clearly, didn't know what he was doing. We just sent this unit round, and it's going to die. But yes, so Bactria here clearly not going to listen, and it's just going to carry on cheating. So that's a shame. That's not going to help with our balance of power issues. And here we go. He's given the order to now carry on the attack. So Rakim Palace Guard are getting ready to turn around. And that's not a pull through there, what I did there. That's just the unit readjusting, and apparently they have to go through the entire unit to do so. The Galatian Royal Guard aren't going to go in. He's going to pull them back, but it doesn't really matter, I don't think. They're going to waver, they're going to break, and they're going to die. And it looks like Kush is sending up some heavy onager crew now. That's a good sign. The crew is being sent up, that means they're out of ammo. So we don't have to worry about artillery ammo anymore from Kush, and I think that might be the same with the Gallic Ballista, though I'm not sure. Where is... Oh, okay, the Arvani is going to look like he's going to assault around here, as is Kush. It looks like Bactria is going to be left with the job of assaulting this slope here, which, in fairness, probably not a nice slope to assault. You've got arch towers here and here that are going to shoot at you. I mean, this place here is also not very nice. I've got more Rakim Palace Guard ready here. Look at these boys. Ready in formation. Shield wall. Very nice. They will hold to the last. What was that guy there? He's had Gorkin, he was. No Gorkin in this army. But then again, two arch towers here. That could be very, very handy. We've got another one here. This one's just in range of this choke point here, but it won't be necessary, I don't think, because it looks like we're going to defend down here and hold this choke point, which is probably better. That allows us a little bit more like space. We just need the space to spread our troops out, just in case they have archers, because we don't want them just to surround us in every single spot where they can just rain arrows in here. We need to keep a little bit of an area safe for defending our troops, which at the moment is this temple. This is the area that we're going to use to like just defend our troops, because they still have a lot of ammo, I think. Bactria certainly is looking like he's got ammo left. He's firing it. Yep, all this ammo down here. They're going to just loose into the... it looks like the swordsman up here. I mean, it's a very hard shot that they're trying to pull off. So luckily that's... Like, they've not got a great angle, so that's lucky. They're at the top. They're at the top of this hill. Archers can't really see what they're doing. I think it's at the edge. Well, it's not near the edge of their range at all. Bactria sent up some reserves here. I don't think they're going to be needed yet, but Who knows? And here we go. The Arvani is engaged down here against more Rakim Palace Guard. The unit losing decisively already. This just happens because the arrow attacks. Look at them. They're just firing like mad. They're like, oh my god. Fire every arrow we have. Good thing these things don't run out of ammo because they're going to be necessary in this defense against these Oathsworn. Or these, I think these are chosen swords, actually. These are chosen swords. But when the Oathsworn do appear, you can also need the ammo then. And they've broken their shield wall, which is fine. But hopefully they can match these swords. I think they kill still can. They're down to 62. Wow. Lost six men of their own. Those Rakim Guard are going to be pretty nasty. Going to take a long time to break through them. Looks like Arvani's actually going to try and take out both these two spots here. Balance of power still not looking good. Looks like, if anything, it's got worse. Can the defenders do this? I mean, you've probably seen the title of the video, and you probably thought, well, the defenders are going to win this, but maybe not. At this rate, it's looking very, very bad. And we've defended the city well, which is why I gave it the title I have given it. But we may not win this. Egypt's looking very low on the ground. But we are going to hold off this first wave. And we've got Bactrian Royal Guard getting ready. I don't know why they're being set up yet. We've still got a very fresh unit here of Rakim Palace Guard. No need to really send these guys in. But Noble Spears, or Spear Nobles, I should say, being set up now to take over. Kush is going to set up his archers. Not a bad idea, since Bactria is kind of revealing his men. And there's no real need to. There you go. I gave him the order. I said, move forward if you're going to do this. If you're going to come and join, move forward. They're going to throw their javies first at the Spear Nobles. And they are killing quite a few Rakim Guard from doing so. But look at that. That is a formidable defense. Lots of Rakim Guard. Lots of Bactrian Nobles. Pile of bodies in front of them. But if they carry on standing here, they are going to get shot. I mean, they are actually killing a lot of Rakim Guard. That is nasty. A unit that was very fresh, or lost about 30 men in those two javie shots, though. Oh, that's nasty. Now they're losing more. Here we go. They're going to charge in. They are just going to take fire if they carry on standing here. Here they go. They're going in. And we are out of arrows, by the way. If you hadn't realized, we have no archers. Elephants on the way, though, by the looks of it. Elephants are looking like they're next on the menu. And here we go. It looks like we're going to have to send some troops forward. What are these? More Bactrian Royal Guard. Or these are the Bactrian Royal Guard. They're going in. We might need some pikes up here, since we don't have arrows. Like fire arrows to scare the elephants. I mean, we do have the arrow towers which are firing fire arrows, so that could be useful, but we might need pikes up here, because pikes are fairly good against anti-infantry, anti-cavalry and elephants, sorry. And they're good against anti-infantry, obviously good against infantry as well. But we'll see. Well, any pikes get sent forward? They still have a lot of arrows through the attackers, so don't really want to focus down yet. These elephants are also pretty bloodied up from their first engagement. As you can see on, like, the troops, like, the crew up here. I don't know how the crew have got so much blood. But the Rakim Guard do also have an anti-cav ability of their own, and they can... Well, here you go. It's pikes going forward. It's going to be Nabatea's pikes are going to go in. And there you go. A lot of them dying now. A lot of elephants already dead. Losing decisively. That's huge. And these pikemen are now going up. Are they going to get any kills? I don't think so. Looks like they're going to get no kills. They might get this one. Oh, they're just charging in. And there you go. I gave them the order to fall back because these elephants are no longer a threat. And there we go. We've beaten everything in this first wave. That's excellent. And here we go. It looks like it's going to be Bactrian Royal Guard. And this is it. This is all that's holding back against these archers. There's stuff back here. There's an elephant all the way back here. What's it doing here? What's he doing here? You're late to the battle, man. Get up there. You're supposed to be out of control as well. So he's probably actually going to kill some of his own archers doing this. Oh no, he's not out of control anymore. A shame. But here we go. The elephants are broken. That is them gone. A huge win for the defenders. Those elephants could have been really handy late game. I mean, because this is not late game yet, you could say. There's still 30 minutes in the battle. And, well, there's a lot of reserves left the defenders have yet to use up. Egypt. Oh, it looks like pikes being sent by Thorax. Pikes being sent forward. They've had enough. The order's been given to send them back, though. These two depleted units of, well, of Egypt's going to hold it. Yeah, these pikes need to fall back. Otherwise, they're just going to javy in. Lots of archers coming up now. Pull back the pikes. They need to move really quick. Yep, there they go. They're falling back. Not lost too many men. But yeah, this is worrying. Still, Gaul still has a lot of arrows. So does Kush. They're just going to shoot our pikemen, which is a real problem because we have nothing to respond with. These spear nobles, again, are going to be killed off, it looks like. They're losing. This Rakim Palace Guard also losing, though. But, I mean, it's these Bactrian Guard down here. They're gonna do the business. Hold the line. This is all it's becoming now. A choke point over here. Choke point after choke point. As we just hold them back, and the arrow towers are just doing their work. Look at the amount of the arrows that each one fires. About four, isn't it, every time? Three or four. And, like, it's doing damage to each unit that gets sent up. They're already down to 73. We joined, like, this little engagement when they're at 92. So they've lost a lot. And here we go. We've got a fight going on down here. And Bactrian Royal Guard and some Noble Swordsmen have been sent down. We've got a unit of Rakim Palace Guard, 63. They're going to hold the top of the hill, make sure they don't. No pull-throughs happen, or if they do, they get punished. No Bactria's tricks now. He's showed his cards far too early. He's 53 and 85, Bactrian Royal Guard. He's got Thorax Swords left. Then it's Archers, and that just seems like it. He's all I know. He's got some more Thorax Swords than Bactrian Royal Guard, but very little. Bactria's nearly out. He's lost his elephants, which is his real, like, final card, really. He's got archers, which is, in fairness, is probably actually a fairly good unit to have at this point, especially since they have ammo. He's just saving it, I think, till the next time any pikes emerge. But yes, the siege, when we did it originally, went on for hours. And at the time that I was playing this siege, it was like, well, it had gone 4 o'clock in the morning when I started. And every minute it was getting lighter and lighter. And yeah, by the end of the battle, it was daytime. It was a long siege. I think it was about 7 o'clock by the time it finished. Mainly because it's obviously not going to be that long for you. I haven't really done much. There probably won't be too much editing because there is constant fighting going on. But it's more just, I think, the lag. There's just lag in the battle just because it's the connection between people from across the world. But yeah, it went on for a long time. And it was brutal. Brutal. It really took all my energies just to focus on what was going on. And here we go. It looks like I realized this was happening. I was like, Aiden, send forward your Galatian Royal Guard. They're going to need to face their Celtic brothers, the Oathsworn, and they're going to have to take them out. Celts versus Celts. Yes, the elite tramping here. Look at, you can hear him. Dun, 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 dun. They march forward ready. And here we go. They've another choke point that they have to hold. I mean, the tower has actually been taken by the Oathsworn. And he's going to throw javies. An okay volley. Most really missing. They're getting a few of them up there. But they're going to just reply with their own volley. That'll take out a couple. Still yet to really have a fight here. Every time the pikes get sent forward, now the Thorax pikes of Egypt, they just get their archers ready and they're like, right, we're going to start shooting. But here we go. I think the order's been given. Oathsworn are going to go in. And they should hold for a little while, should these... Glacian Royal Guard and these Sauric Swords. And they're pretty battered units, both of them. Oh, pikes have been sent forward as well. Interesting decision. These pikes are going to be a focus of the enemy. They're going to definitely try and focus these guys down. They are pulling back, and there you go. You see, that's all that's going to happen. They're going to fall back, and now the pikes are going to fall back. And this just isn't a good trade-off. It's using the power of Cushes, which is really huge, but it's not worth constantly just walking backwards and forwards. You might as well just leave them. These units here are going to hold fine. He's got plenty of stuff in reserve. He's got another Galatian Royal Guard that could go forward. And he's got more pikes, but we don't, which is fine. But he doesn't want to throw away one just yet. Now there's pikes being sent down by Nabatea. They're actually looking the wrong way. Not a good sign. You definitely want to turn them around. Especially with Bactra having some ammo left. Here we go. He's starting to just fire a few shots. And there we go. Pikes are out. Pikes are down. And they can join this fight. And this will certainly turn the course of the battle. This Thorax Sword unit here, very fresh, but they should actually start to push these guys back now. Look at them. You're like in the back here and you're just looking, you like see all these pikes just waving in the air and like, oh god, now it's going to be tough. If it wasn't already tough before against Royal Guard and Noble Swords, it's even tougher now. Got some Thorax Pikemen in here. Nabataean Thorax Pikemen. They're very heavy pikes apparently. Just does surprise me. What are the... actually, Thorax pikemen are also very heavy. Maybe most pikes are just heavy. I know that normal pikemen aren't. And Kush's pikes aren't, which Kush still does have a unit of pikes, which could be handy when it comes to having to fight all these pikes that the defenders have. We have to remember, at this point, I think only one unit of pikemen has been lost for either side. But the attackers have come as factions with, well, Arvani, for instance, don't have any pikes. There's been a lot more pikemen lost because Bactria sent up a lot of his pikemen onto the walls and they just got focused down and killed. So I think the attackers lost about three of their four units of pikemen before they got to this final stage of attacking, which could come in into a bear. But they have got archers, which are very good at taking out pikemen. And elephants, well, they had elephants as well, but they're all gone now. Rip. But here we go, more stuff being sent up. And it looks like Kush is sending in archers. This is a great sign. Archers are being sent up. That means they're out of ammo. That means, we're going to be looking a lot better soon. More Rakim Palace Guard being sent up, looks like, at some point. Running low, though. We're at 21 and 62. It's looking really low. Might need to send some more stuff up. It looks like it might be time to send up. Here we go. It looks like it's one of the final units being sent up. Yep, this is the final unit. We've got Rakim Palace Guard down here as well. Now ready to just help fight out here. Shotal Warriors, Armored Shotal Warriors. They've got 65 men left and Silver Chevrons. They've got 500 kills. Wow. These guys have done well. 500 kills and counting. They are still alive. There's still about half their unit left. This is, I mean, a good defense here now. These Palace Guard really are thick in this line. That is not going to break for a while. Archers could be handy in there, to be fair. I know that they are waiting to look for pikes again, because that is the real problem. But that is not a bad, target either. Over here, it looks like Oathsworn are winning in their fight against the Glacian Royal Guard. Not good. Because, well, if they can get down here, then they can start to surround over here and threaten this. So the general is being sent up of Egypt. General is being sent up. And he's actually being focused down by archers. Which is also, again, not a bad target for them to take out. Taking out generals at this point. It's not as scummy as taking them out at the beginning. I would say. Because at this point, it is kind of a valid tactic to try and break through. or certainly break the morale. But I mean, these Galatian Royal Guard here, definitely, I'm surprised. Like, they cost more than Osworn and they're being beaten. It's not like they like being overwhelmed and flanked at all. Not at all. How far are those? Is the general off? He's stopped actually where he is. He really needs to carry on because his archer tower has now changed sides. And now more troops are being sent up. Looks like there's going to be some disciples of Apidemac. I could never pronounce that name, but oh well. Osworn, yeah, are going to win that fight. They have numbers and they now says they're winning decisively. Keen Palace Guard still holding the line. More Osworn being set up, but basically a fresh unit. I think that's the last one. Oh no, maybe not. Not the last unit of Osworn. They still got some. Not quite fresh though, both of them. And here we go. We've got more troops in here now. We've got more Osworn. The Kush Archers are still here. This is really good. And the Keen Palace Guard have been sent in the final unit. Nabatea over here, pushing back. Actually, Bactria's still here as well. Can't forget Bactria. Did such a great defense early on. At the wall, at the gate. Held back two armies, basically, on his own. How many kills are these pikemen on? That's going to be of interest. 68. Not as many as I'd hoped. Not much fighting going on here, actually, to be honest. I think this elephant carcass here is kind of stopping any fighting going on. Both sides kind of just happy to hang back. And they're really sending everything right now with Bactria. They've got the general and... well, just everything in there. Palace Guard here now losing decisively. I think they're about to waver. All they need to do is just make sure that they don't get up to the top of this hill and capture these towers. Which are doing just fine now. They are doing just fine. Like, if I could tell how many kills the Archtower's got, that would be insane. Oh, the pikes are falling back. And they're getting sent back in now. There we go. Okay, this was interesting. So, there must have been some miss. I think... at this point, I was like, right, I'm pulling back because we're getting a little bit too far forward for my liking. But the Bactria player was like, no, we're still doing okay. And he is pulling through again, his Bactria here. He's pulling through and surrounding this Noble Royal Guard unit. But he's getting punished for it. Pikes are hard to pull through. You die usually if you do it. And now he's sending forward... well, I'm sending forward Rakim Palace Guard, a very weak unit. Noble Swords in there as well. Well, the pikes, yeah, they'll do their bit. They'll kill these guys. And these Bactrian Royal Guard might have just been saved because of that. Those Palace Guard getting sent in there. It's hard to tell where the fighting starts and begins because they all have very similar tunics. Like, the Nabataeans have fairly reddish tunics. And then there's also Bactria fighting Bactria here. And here we go. The pikes setting up. Now it's time to do their deadly poke. I like that they just keep saying like insults like, that man is annoying. That's their insult. Okay, and Bactria has lost. Well, not lost, but... well, yeah, he's lost his unit, but he's not lost entirely. Because now Nabatea is here to take over. It's a thin line holding them all back. The pike's just getting ready. I think Bactria must be out of ammo. That's also huge. Yeah, they're all cheering back here. Cheering with their swords out. Again, like I mentioned earlier, a good sign to tell whether they are out of ammo. And Nabatea is now in it. He's lost quite a few men just doing that, but it might be worth it. They're breaking here as well. Look at this, it's very deplenished. So few men left here fighting this, like, little engagement. And just Rakim Palace Guard here pushing through, and then there's Egypt's now, like, well, bringing up his reserves to make sure that they get back into the fight. But there's still a few nasty units. Got Armatures Warriors here. I think that's the last unit. Oh no, there's another one back here. Of course, there's always another unit. That's the worry. There's another unit. And another unit. And here we go. Disciples of Atapenmac. What's he got here? Pikes. Ready to face them. And his general. They did actually see off those Oathsworn, it seems. That's good. The Lion Boys are next. Neither side holds the tower. That's actually fine. As long as they don't hold the tower, that's fine. Us holding the tower, that would be lovely. But it's not going to be, it would seem. And here we go. Thorax Pikemen have been set up to face other pikes. Here we go. This is going to be the make or break, I think, here. If this unit of pikemen for Kush breaks, then that is worrying. But yeah, look at that. They are getting rinsed. The Thorax Pikemen here, absolutely rinsing them. Wow. They got rinsed. Well, destroyed. If you don't know what rinse means, it means destroyed. And that's what they were. And that last pikeman there just stabbed with the Byrakim guard. Excellent. Here we go. The next line is coming up. And this area here is covered in bodies. Look at the amount of dead men here. This is awful. Awful. But they're getting ready. Making up their bracing, ready for this charge, and it looks like it's going to be Oathsworn coming in. And they're actually dying quite quickly again. These Oathsworn, combat even, but they lost about 10 men in that first initial charge. Rakim Palace Guard here holding okay. They're doing great. They're probably the MVPs of this game. Rakim Palace Guard, they've just been holding everywhere. They're literally on every front. Down here, they're on the north, I guess you call this the north wall, but it's not really a wall. North defense. They're over here at this one. They are actually losing this now. But there is going to be Bactrian Royal Guard sent in. The general for Bactria being sent in. They're definitely going to be needed with Armored Shota Warriors coming in. Those pikes might need to be sent back again. But it's just the fear of what the Arvani and Kush have left in their stores of ammunition. They clearly don't have any ammo left on their ballista because the crew's now up here. Though I don't think that thing's been firing for a while, so it doesn't really matter. General now coming up, the Royal Peltasts. And these, yeah, look at this. This unit here is now just redundant. It's going to have to stand here for a while these pikemen just stand and look at them. Because the pikes can just stay there and the disciples will just have to run into them. Or they can go back down this way and they can just go and just charge in this choke point here, which is probably what they'll end up doing. It looks like he's setting up his other pikeman unit, getting it ready, probably to go into here. Not that it's going to be needed yet. And the pikes are going up for Bactria. And that will be interesting. And Bactria is now sending up his archers. And here we go, we've been victorious on this side. And the balance of power is slowly going back in our favour because we did that. But there's still a lot of attackers left. And we are running out of stuff very quickly. I'm down to my last two units. It looks like Egypt's getting ready to send up stuff. It doesn't really need its Thorax pikes over here yet. We've got pikes in here. Yeah, and here we go. Bactria's setting up his general. And his swords. Setting up a lot. Everything, basically. His archers. Everything. How many kills are those pikes on now, I wonder? 219, that's not too shabby at all. But I'm not moving on because I'm not sure where the Arvani is with their archers. I know that they're still alive at this point. And also I don't know what they've got left. Kush is now firing in. So these pikemen are going to be taking a bit of a beating. They're actually down to 74. Not a good sign. But they are now in the defense of the Rakim Palace Guard, who always seem to be able to defend. And they should be able to hold. Should be able to hold now. Because they've got shields to defend that protect them. And they've also got their own general, of course. They have their own general. And Bactria's going to pull out. an interesting decision. I guess he's just realized the pike's there. It's just not worth doing. So the last fight is really over here between Arvani and Kush and Nabateo in Egypt. And Egypt's getting ready to send up his pikes as well. He's going to force them back. I think it is because we have realized that they are running low on ammo. We can't see Arvani's archers. I know they're Gallic hunters, so they can hide. But we should be able to see them, I think, if they're inside the city walls. And the pikes are getting ready. I think they're going to go forward. Yeah, here they come. So they'll force back these armor shield warriors. And the they're going to force them back. Even though I don't think they're breaking. They're just falling back because they know it's just not worth standing here. And the Oathsworn are going to be the only ones holding as the pikes go in. Looking around, looking for some kills. And there they go, they fall back as well. And that's it. That assault here is basically done. Egypt's going to carry on forward. He's going to force them back a little bit more. Looks like Kush is not firing. Yeah, he looks like he's out of ammo. Kush, I think, is out of ammo as well. So it's whether Arvani has any ammo is the real question. It is the real question. I'm going to fast forward because there is a little delay in just basically anyone attacking. They're now repositioning the attackers for the final assault. Try and break us through. With balance power looks like it's about even again. A really, really good sign. These Rakim Palace Guard are here basically to stop any jabbies basically coming through on these Thorax Pikes. That's all they're here for. That's all they're going to stand here and do. Just take all the ammo. Actually, here we go. We've got our first fight. Looks like Kush is already going to send in troops. His armor show warriors already going in against pikes. How are they faring? Not well, losing decisively. Yeah, not good at all. These pikes are going to munch through these guys. Especially since they're supported by spears. So the spears can kind of give them protection as the pikes can just attack from a little bit further back. This is a really good formation that's being formed here. So well done on Bactria. He's not given up. He lost so much of his army early on, but he's really like getting a lot of kills here. A from the arch tower and B from his pikes. He's sacrificed so much. This is his last two units, I think. This is it. It for Bactria. And he's taking a lot of Kush with him. And there you go. The armor shield warriors, 33 and going down. And they're breaking. And now archers are going in. Kush is just going to send in his archers, it would seem. And here we go. Found the Gallic Hunters. They are over here. They are ready. And I made the smart decision of not putting any palace, like removing these palace guard. I removed the pikes because I was like, well, we don't need them there anymore. But they can quite happily go back and support this small unit. 43 silver chevrons. I'm sure these guys have a lot of kills as well. 267. Wow. Interesting to see all the end results. And here we go. It looks like the Gallic Hunters are going to start going up. A worrying sign that they're having to send up archers at this point now with the attackers. So it is looking like it's now... It is in the defender's favour as this battle. As they're just losing men by the minute. Just sending them in. And they're just dying on the pikes. Like, these pikes are going to become kebabs by the end of it. They're going to have so many dead bodies just piled up on them. And there you go. Look at this. Bactria just sending in his elite Persian archers, if I can pronounce them. And they're just running in and they're dying. Run in, die. Run in, die. Yep, look at that. And they're getting shot by the arch towers as well. So these guys, I'm sure, won't hold long. And there we go. It's just the archers over here now fighting. Looks like it's going to be the same with Arvani. He's just got archers. And he's got a general of Kush, but it's cavalry. And they don't fare well against pikes. And the pikes have been sent back up. Here we go. This is going to be it. This is all that's going to be sent in. That's all that's... I mean, we're on bare bones here. And we were like... We can't assault. We don't want to assault. We've got so little left. It's going to be more Oathsworn sent over. Some beating up units. They're going to try and force their way through against these pikes by the looks of it. Some Galatian Royal Guard being sent over to support them, possibly. Interesting to see what happens. And here we go. It looks like the Oathsworn are going to get sent in. No. They just keep wanting to get a little bit closer. They're just like, yep, no. Not quite sure whether they want to go in yet. There you go, the archers. They're finished. That was it. Look at the piles of dead bodies here. This is like slowly gone from all the way back here where we started like the original fight. And now it's all the way here the dead bodies are getting to. This is a bloody mess. A bloody mess. Look at these brave men holding to the last. They've done well with those pikes. They've done well. I mean, they've done well over here as well. They've done every side of the defenders have done excellent. Like, look at these pikes here. Like, also, they haven't killed all these. This is killed by, like, other waves, but they've done a good job. They killed so many guys over here. If they could pull out some ammunition now, I kept seeing these Celtic Ballista guys back on the by their artillery, and I was like, they're going to pull more ammo out of nowhere, aren't they? I got really worried about that. And here we go. There's a pullback going on by the defenders. We decided that we'd to hold them here. So I sent in my Rakeem Palace Guard. And these guys are going to hold them back. The Royal Peltasts also going to try and hold these guys back. There's 13 of them. Well, going down quickly. These guys are going to try and hold them back while the rest of the Egyptian army gets back. A brave honour the Nabataeans are doing here for Egypt. A great honour, in fact. Not a brave honour. It's a brave gesture, though. Sacrifice their lives so these guys can get back. But these are pikes, so they are very useful. And it looks like the disciples of Epidamac are going to just capture as many towers as possible. It's a bit late now. They could have gone and done this earlier. They could have come all the way around here and captured this. And really threatened this side. If they'd threatened this side, the attackers... Like, that was one of the mistakes I thought they made. They had so many troops left. They could have attacked some multiple fronts. And it would have taken, like... It would have meant that they couldn't attack in great force on every side. But they could actually force us to, like, defend more choke points. We've only had to defend 3 so far. 4 if you kind of count this area here. And that was fine. We had enough troops to do 4. If they made it a 5th, maybe that would be a problem. And this is harder to defend. And it certainly would have meant we'd have to have one down here. We'd have to have one on the wall. Or defending the walls. So that would have been a 5th and a 6th. Which should have been a real shame. For us. But the attackers could have really used that. Here we go. It looks like he's just going to send in his Osworn against pikes. He's got 2 units of pikes here. He's pulling 1 back. But yeah, these are poor Osworn. I think the player knows what's going to happen as well. He just doesn't really want to have to do it. But... For the sake of the length of the battle, he has to. They played their cards. It didn't quite go right. And we've looked like we're going to win this. The defenders are probably going to win this. There's not much left. They're just sending stuff in to die now. Like these pikes over here, for instance. They're doing so well. How many of them left? 53. An elite unit now. Yeah, there's not even that many guys here, and they're just dying. Here we go, over on the other side, Gaul. I keep wanting to call them Gaul, the Gallic Hunters, though. They are Gallic Hunters, so no wonder I'm wanting to call them Gaul. Are attacking, and here come the pikes and spears. And they're pushing back the elephant. That much force behind them, they're that eager. Oh, nice little fight here. He's just like, oh, cut down, cut down. The general's trying to go up here for Kush. This is never going to end well. Trying to fight pikemen. And the arch tower's here, still firing away. And the sun carries on beating down on the backs of these thorax pikemen and their Rakeem Palace Guard. That Rakeem Palace Guard unit's been there since the beginning. Like, when they first came up here and we... And they charged their elephants up and they sent in their first units of Bactrian infantry. And then they did this pull through. They've been there since the beginning. Through thick and thin. They've been there. They've held. That's what Palace Guard do. They're defending the palace. The last man. They keep poking away. And look at this. Just cavalry's just going to die. I don't know if the general's dead yet, but he soon will die. There he is. I think that's him anyway. That guy there. Looks like it might be him. with his golden helmet. Here he goes, going in, dead. Pretty sure that is him actually dead. No, coverage sustained, not dead yet. Oh, maybe it's not him, that's just a fancy looking guy then. That might be him here actually in the orange, I don't know. I've kind of given up looking. It used to be able to tell who the general was in like with the old classic Rome 2. Can't tell now really who the general is. But yeah, look at this. They actually might break through here. They got Spain of pikes ready. But this is a lot of units and they're getting fairly close. These Thorax pikes are tired. I don't know how. Not really been fighting. They are winning though, so that's good. And here we go. We're now going around. We're now surrounding them. We've literally marched the entire way around because there's nothing left there after we destroy that small unit of Oathsworn. They're just going to charge into the pikes. These cavalry. What a, again, a stupid decision.
So, as Kush loses his general like this,
so does the Arvani. It's actually going to be Bactria that's going to have the his only general left. Probably the player that made the most mistakes and, well, also did a few dubious moves, we'll call it like that. And there you go, look at them charging the pikes. They're pushing on. They don't care. 40 of them left now. Everything else breaking. Yeah, I think they've lost their general now. Yeah, oh, he's certainly broken anyway. He's gone. That's everything gone there. And there you go, the balance of power. It's surely going to be a victory for the defenders. Very little left. Everything's breaking for Bactrian. It's just his general left. So there you go. The battle is won. Everything is breaking. So I hope you guys have enjoyed this battle. It was an epic one. And what a way to defend a city. To the very last man. This has probably been one of the longest and hardest siege battles I've had to fight in a long time. So kudos to the attackers. They did very well and certainly challenged us a great deal. And I did think for a long time we were going to lose this battle. It was just how many we could take down with them. But also thank you to Dodgy Gob and Aiden for taking part in it. It was a struggle and they know. Hope they can join me for many more sieges to come. But there you go. The Galatian Royal Guard. Gonna go around Rakim Palace Guard, gonna my general, gonna surround them, and this is it. Bactria breaks. Just like that. And it's a costly victory, it certainly was, but victory all the same. And we'll have a look at the end results. So Nabatea, who I was playing as, got a fair amount of kills with our archers, about 166 was our best. Pikes gained 517. That pikeman unit that's fighting those Kush's general and all those archers got that many kills. It was excellent. My Noble Swordsman getting 105, the best one. My Rakim Palace Guard, I would arguably say was the MVP of the battle. They did very well. They were fighting on every front at one point. 277 was the best. Many of them getting over 100 kills as well. So excellent to them. Dodgy Gob, who was playing as one of the Bactrian armies. He did very well, holding back the Arvani and the other Bactrian army for a long time on his own, really. So his cavalry didn't do too great in that sally out. But it was a worthy sacrifice in the end. His archers getting 102, that's okay. Probably could have got more if he'd saved some of his ammo for late game, but it was well worth it in the end, it would seem. It did not matter. His pikes getting 481, that small unit did just destroyed them. They did excellent in that choke point. And then Bactrian Royal Guard getting about 140 kills is their best. And then his Thorax Swords, 172. A very good result for them, actually. And then Aiden, who was playing as Egypt, going 195 with his Rhodian Slingers, 194 with his Cretan Archers. Excellent amount of kills here with his Archers. Did very well. His General getting 122. Excellent there. Probably the best out of any of his Royal Peltas units. 101 for his Galatian Royal Guard. They didn't actually perform as well as I'd hoped they would. They seemed to just, well, get minced quite quickly. His Thorax Swords actually did better getting 138. That's very, it was fairly good actually. Thoros Spears getting 77, so that's pretty average for them. And then his pikes getting 236, which is very good in a normal battle, but in today's, well, it's bang average, it would be, unfortunately for him. But yes, then we'll move on to the attackers. So we have Cabo Thunder, I'm presuming that's Thunder Nut, I don't know, playing as Kush, getting 150 one kills with his Kushite archers. I just saw that. Wow. The other one getting 115. That's not bad either. His swords, I said they were pretty awful, but they're actually nearly getting 200 kills. So that's pretty impressive. His show to war is getting 339. So for the cheap version, they did excellent as well. Like the cheap version of show to warriors, they did well. Then he got 627 with armor show to warriors. So the best unit on the battlefield so far here, like for kills, but it did not matter. They died. They died very, very a painful death. And then his African heavy onagers getting 147, which isn't awful either for an artillery unit. Then Reese's is pieces. He's playing as the Arverni, getting 220 kills with his Gallic Hunters. Excellent. The rest getting over 100 kills as well. His Chosen Swordsman, the best, getting 173. His Ballista getting 86, which is not awful either. Actually, no. Chosen Swords here getting 245. Even better. Excellent. Probably actually one of his best results for any of his infantry. His Oathsworn, most of them getting over 100 kills. Most of them getting over 200 kills. Actually, this one getting 291, that's excellent. And then his Spear Nobles getting 83. Then Treyway, his Elephants only getting 44, a real shame. They could have been great last, like late game there. They could have really broken through a lot of stuff. And then he just didn't seem to get any good results. He like only got 1,000 kills in comparison to most of the other people playing that got nearer 2,000 or 3,000 in the cases of the Arverni. His best unit probably was this Bactrian Royal Guard here getting 156. So it was a real shame he did lose, make some mistakes early on, and he pulled through, so he kind of deserved it for his karma. Probably a little bit, that's kind of what you get. But anyway guys, I hope you enjoyed this battle, and if you did, please do leave a like and comment and subscribe. I know it was a long one, I hope you guys enjoyed, and I hope you guys enjoyed Siege Week. And let me know in the comments whether you want to see another one in the future. And please just stay safe and stay inside and stay healthy. And until next time, Legionnaires,